Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with the lead editorial. Now today's lead editorial is very important for international relations because a very important event has unfolded in Nepal, and this event is about the unification between the political parties of communists in Nepal. Now the communist parties that are functioning and operating currently in Nepal, earlier they used to be adversaries, they were actually antagonistic to each other, but of late the communist party of Maoists and the communist party of Marxist Leninists, they have decided to unify for the November elections. For the upcoming elections. Now, why this event is important for the current diplomatic perspective? Now, this is important because the communists, they have come together not out of their own rapprochement or out of their own agreement, but this agreement has been forced on them by China. Now, why China has played an important role in the unification of the Maoist and the Marxist and Leninist? What is the reason behind that? The reason is, now if we assess the polity of Nepal, it is actually a core communist nation. Though we have other communist nations like Russia and China, but they are only communists at their face. When we look at the entirety of communism that is present in any country in the present scenario, it is actually the Nepal that stands out. Now Nepal is a communist nation because most of the political parties are having left orientation, though it is not a communist country as such. Now because the political parties are communist, the China, in order to assert itself, has triasted with these communist parties, and it has actually supported these communist parties. And these communist parties, they have always been against India. Against India. Why? Why they have always been against India? We need to understand that. Now, in order to understand this aspect, we actually need to go in the history of Nepal. Now, Nepal, when it got its independence during the same years like that of India, at that point of time, it was ruled by the Rana dynasty. And after the Rana dynasty, the multi-party system got institutionalized in Nepal. Though India was not in favor of the Rana dynasty, but when the rule was institutionalized in the favor of multi-party system, India had supported Nepal. But after that, again, the monarchical system was established in Nepal. And the Maharaja Mahendra of that time was not in favor of India. He was actually more in favor of Nepal. And that was one of the reasons why the economic blockade was imposed on Nepal by Rajiv Gandhi. But during 1990s, the forces of communism, the communist parties, they were actually trying to wage a war against the monarchy because they wanted to institutionalize a liberal kind of a communistic setup. And it was during this time that the communist parties got really against India because they were deriving the support from China. So these communist parties got aligned with China and monarchy got aligned with India. So India had interest in sustaining the rule of the monarchy in Nepal. So that was in India's interest. And at that point of time, India had supported the King Gyanendra in Nepal. So whosoever had been the Prime Minister of Nepal from the communist parties, be it the Maoist or be it the Marxist and the Leninist, they have never supported India. And after the monarchy was trampled with, the monarchy was done away with, in 2001, the forces of communism had actually strengthened themselves. So primarily after the incoming of the new constitution in 2005, the new problem had unfolded on the territory of Nepal. And this was the problem, this problem related to the problem of the plain regions. Because earlier I have already told you that the communist party, they were always against India. And most of the communist parties that we have, they actually belong to the hilly region of Nepal. Be it the communist party, Maoist, Marxist, Leninist, or be it the Nepali Congress. Now all these political parties, they take into consideration only the interest of the hilly region. They've never taken into consideration the interest of the people lying in the plains. So India had to support the people lying in the plain regions. India wanted to stand behind them so that they can have voice in the politics of Nepal. Because communists, they will never become true friends of India. They have always been aligned with China because of the same kind of ideological system. So this had created further fissures between India and communist political parties. Now these political parties, they have come together, so it is going to create a big trouble for India. So from diplomatic point of view, it is a big loss to India's diplomatic maneuvering. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. And you can also order the video classes on brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice, nice day.